Hi Anna. My name's Linda James and I live in Devon. Never done this before, so it's a bit daunting, but I've watched your videos and I like what I see and what I hear, and I watched the video from the lady in Burnley yesterday evening, and it resonates. I feel exactly the same way. Since the start of this, I thought, yeah, okay, it's a bit peculiar what's going on. The mass hysteria and the fear. But honestly, I thought it would calm down. And instead, what has happened over weeks is this systemic mantra by the media of keeping people in fear. Every time you switch something on, there is nothing being talked about but cases of COVID, people dying, what their experiences, what people's experiences have been, who have had it, nothing positive whatsoever. The information that's being given out on television. I stopped watching the news a long time ago. I'm talking years and years ago, because I don't believe a word that comes across. I think it's all manipulated. That's how I feel. That's how I felt for a long, long time. So I do my own research and I try to take a balanced view, as I have done with this situation. But it's becoming increasingly more difficult because there is no balance, basically. And now we have the wearing of face coverings in shops. And this morning, the government have imposed a 14-day quarantine for people coming over from Spain. So, yes, dark and sinister, absolutely. And like your woman from Burnley, I think she was from. I've gone from a feeling, okay, I can work with this. Excuse me. I can wait it out like everybody. I can try and take a balanced view, although I don't believe anything of what's going on. To now, I'm feeling in my solar plexus, this knot of anxiety that I feel as if I'm in a spider's web. And I absolutely refuse to wear a mask or a face covering. Absolutely. I haven't been to a doctor for over 30 years. I'm supposedly in one of the vulnerable groups because I'm 70. I haven't had an illness. I have nothing wrong with me. I am not wearing a face covering. End of story. I've done my own research and I just believe that it's more harmful than not. But I think now, excuse me, I think now it's political. I think Boris Johnson is just looking to make sure that it's just all for political gain. And I think the one question that I am constantly asking myself is, in any of these situations, these quick turns, these overnight decisions, who actually stands to gain overall? Who is standing to gain from manipulating us in this way? There are many answers to that, but one thing I am absolutely certain of, without question, is I will not have a vaccine. I don't do vaccine. I'm not anti-vax. You want it, you have it. I'm not anti-mask. You want to wear it, you wear it. But don't impose your restrictions on me because I'm fine. I'm fine. I keep myself ultra healthy. And I'm okay, you know. In Devon, here in Devon, we have had hardly anything. I think there was 11 reported cases. There's nothing now, hasn't been for weeks, and we've had an influx since the 4th of July. We've had a massive influx of holidaymakers because we're right on the coast, and they are streaming in off the M5. And I said, this is three and a half weeks ago, and they're still streaming in, and there is not one reported case to my knowledge. I don't know anybody in my vast circle of friends and acquaintances. I don't know one person who's even had symptoms of COVID. Not one. Not in Spain, because I lived in Spain for a long time. I'm in constant contact with people in Spain. Not one person I know has had any symptoms, anything whatsoever. Now, that is a vast number of people that I personally know. So, you know, I just, what the heck is going on? And I am just, I'm now getting more and more worried about the effects of this long term on children, on young people. We're teaching them to live in fear, and fear is your first emotion, you know. So what's this going to do to them? I'm so frustrated. I've got grandchildren, and two in Spain and three here, and you know, what's this teaching them? What are we teaching them? What messages are we passing on here? You know, and this constant mantra of we're all in this together is absolute bull, because everybody looks out for themselves. Yes, there might be small pockets, and yes, the media are constantly showing communities pulling together, which is great and fantastic, but they're not giving a balanced view whatsoever. And now I thought, you know, I used to think Laura Kunzberg was you know, sort of middle of the road, quite balanced. Now I don't at all. As a journalist, I've watched her a couple of times now. I've heard what she's saying to the camera on BBC, and I am absolutely dismayed. Dismayed, because even she talks about the next wave that, you know, anyway, I won't go on. I could go on. Thank you for this opportunity, and you know, I hope we take to the streets, quite honestly. Anyway, thank you, Anna, and you're doing absolutely brilliant, brilliant work. Thank you so much. Bye.